Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about recent trends in plant breeding. Under this topic, first we will learn about exploiting and enhancing genetic variation. Now this topic itself further divided into objective, activity and new technologies. Under objective, first objective is identifying the existing genetic variation. To complete this objective, we have to do the activity like genetic map and molecular markers. To do this activity, new technology like high throughput technology from genomics to phenomics has been used. Next objective is extending the gene recombination. To complete this objective, activity like gene isolation and transfer has been done. To do this activity, new technology like recombinant DNA technology and GM technology has been used. GM means genetically modified technology. Third objective is enhancing the genetic variation. To complete this objective, we will use random and targeted mutagenesis. The technology which is used to complete this activity is tilling, that means targeted induced local lesion in the genome. Here the oligonucleotide mediated site specific mutagenesis has been used. Tilling is generally reverse genetic technique that combines chemical mutagenesis with PCR based screening to identify point mutation in region of interest. Tilling is a powerful technology that employed heteroduplex analysis to detect which organism in a population carries single nucleotide mutagenesis in specific genes. Tilling can also be used to detect naturally occurring single nucleotide polymorphism in genes among the accession variety or cultivar to study the gene function or to detect genetic markers in population. This is the best method of allele mining without causing damage to the nature. In case of tilling, the procedure what we follow is that first the seeds of our interest will be selected. Now this seed will be incubated in ethyl methyl sulfonate for a particular period of time. After that, these seeds were sown in a particular land up to M4 generation. Usually in case of plant breeding, we will say that F1, F2 generation. But since the seeds are mutated, we call these plants we represent each generation with M1 to M4 generation, up to M4 generation. So we will pull all the high yielding plant or the seeds from M1 generation to M2 generation. Later the DNA will be isolated from that and it will be pulled. This DNA will be amplified through PCR. Since the DNA will be mutated, some DNA segment show heteroduplex. This heteroduplex is due to single nucleotide polymorphism, whereas the DNA with no mutation will be having a homoduplex complex. Now this heteroduplex complex will be cleaved with the help of a enzyme called CEL1, or which is isolated from celery 1. This enzyme will cleave only the heteroduplex nucleotide or single nucleotide polymorphic gene only. So after cleavage, these fragments, both homoduplex and heteroduplex fragments, will be run on the gel, where we will find the difference in the gel band of the DNA. Through this we could able to identify single nucleotide polymorphism. Site directed mutagenesis.
the method to create specific change in the DNA. It could be either insertion, deletion, or substitution to study the gene function. For that, first we need a plasmid, which consists of a particular gene, which represent, like for example, it represent the size of the fruit. If this plasmid consists of a gene which represent a small size of a fruit, we want to remove that gene with the help of a PCR, with the help of a mutagenic primer used in PCR. So this mutagenic primer consists of a gene which represent bigger size of the fruit. After PCR, we will the gene will be amplified. The original gene, which consists of undesirable gene, will be removed with the help of DPN1 digestion. Here, this enzyme will cleave the gene which is methylated. It doesn't cleave the gene which is inserted through primer or PCR primer, because they are not methylated. So after DPN digestion, this plasmid will be transferred to the bacteria through transformation for the multiplication of that plasmid. Later on, the mutant will be selected. In this way, site-directed mutagenesis will be done to create specific change in DNA to study the function, to study its function. Next is markers. In case of markers, it could be biological. Markers are generally referred to measurable indicator of some biological state or condition. They could be biochemical. In that, it could be isozymes or protein banding pattern, or it could be morphological, chromosomal, or molecular. Morphological markers, identification based on morphology, that is a external appearance. Advantages, easily monitored. Disadvantages, affected by environment, limited in number. Some appear later, that means some flower color appear later in plant development, making early scoring impossible. Pleiotropic gene action, complete genome assay required for quantitative trait locus analysis are not feasible. Protein markers or protein molecular markers. Markers related to variation in protein and amino acid banding pattern. It could be either isozyme marker. Here the multiple forms of the same enzyme coded by different genes. Next is allozymes. One enzyme, one locus, two or more allele in a population. Those are called as allozymes. Next is the application. It is used for detection of gene, introgression and recombination, comparative mapping, and determination of genetic diversity and phylogenetic relationship. Advantages. Advantages are like simple, inexpensive, electrophoretically resolvable, and detectable. Does not require DNA extraction or the availability of sequence information, primers, or probe. Quick and easy to use, codominant markers that have high reproducibility. Disadvantages, relatively low abundance and low level of polymorphism. Affected by environmental condition, may change depending on the type of tissue used for the analysis. Molecular markers do not represent target genes themselves, but act as a sign or flags. Genetic markers located in close proximity to genes, that is tightly linked, may be referred to as gene tags. Do not affect the phenotype of the trait of interest because they are located only near or linked to genes controlling the trait. Genetic markers were originally used in genetic mapping to determine the order of genes along chromosomes. Molecular markers include non-PCR based marker, PCR based marker, and sequence based marker. Under non-PCR based markers, restriction fragment length polymorphism is the example, and some of the examples for PCR based markers are RAPD, AFLP, microsatellite, SCAR, CAPS, and in case of sequence based markers, examples which comes under this is SNPR, single nucleotide polymorphism markers. First, we will discuss about non-PCR based markers. Under that, first we will discuss about restriction fragment length polymorphism. Here, the variation in the length of DNA fragment produced by specific restriction endonuclease from genomic DNA of two or more individuals of a species are identified. If two individuals differ by as little as single nucleotide in the restriction site, the restriction enzyme will cut the DNA of one but not the other. Restriction fragment of different length are thus generated. Now, where does this restriction fragment length polymorphism is applicable? It is applicable in intraspecific level or among closely related taxa. Presence or absence of fragment resulting from change in recognition site or used for identifying the species or population, estimating genetic distance and fingerprinting, forensic biological percentage, paternity cases, and disease status and genetic mapping. Now, the procedure of restriction fragment length polymorphism. Here we take three samples, in the which two are control sample and the third one is a mutated sample. So when we take this DNA in an append off tube, to this append off tube we are going to add restriction enzymes which will cut the DNA at particular sequence. Now, this restriction fragments are going to be, restriction fragments from each sample are separated by electrophoresis. Each sample form a characteristic pattern of bands. Now, this gel is used for southern blotting. Here, the capillary action pulls an alkaline solution upward through gel and through a sheet of nitrocellulose paper laid on the top of it, transferring the DNA to the paper and denaturing it in the process. Single-stranded DNA stick to the paper positioned in the band exactly as on the gel. Next is hybridization with radioactive probe. The paper blot is exposed to a solution containing radioactively labeled probe. The probe is a single-stranded DNA complementary to DNA sequence of interest, and it attached to the base pairing to restriction fragment of complementary sequence. Rinse away unattached probe. Later, autography will be done. Here, the sheet of the photographic film is laid over the paper. Radioactivity in the bound probe expose the film to form an image corresponding to the specific DNA bands, the bands containing DNA that base pairs with the probe. The band pattern of sample 1 and 2 are identical, but the third sample is different. In this way, we can identify the mutated sample. Next is PCR based molecular markers. Example is random amplified polymorphic DNA. Any DNA segment that is amplified using short oligo deoxynucleotide primer of arbitrary nucleotide sequence and polymerase chain
reaction procedure. RAPD is also known as APPCR, that is arbitrary primed PCR, DAF or DNA amplification fingerprinting, MAAP, that is multiple arbitrary amplicon polymorphism. RAPD are dominant marker system. RAPDs are dominant markers that require no prior knowledge of the DNA sequence, which makes them very suitable for investigation of species that are not well known. Some of the application of this random amplified polymorphic DNA is that it is used for genetic map, F1 identification, varietal or line identification, breeding, bulk segregant analysis, diversity studies, marker assisted selection, seed testing, map based gene cloning. Principles of RAPD. RAPD are produced by PCR using genomic DNA and arbitrary primer. Tag polymerase is used to amplify DNA segment between closely spaced sequence and complementary to short random oligomer, typically 10 oligomers. Whereas in case of RAPD, the polymorphism result from change in the primer binding site in the DNA sequence. In this picture, you can see that variety A, there are 4 primer binding site resulting two RAPD products. Whereas in case of variety B, lack one primer binding site, this result in only one RAPD marker being produced. So if primer point is in the same direction, then no amplification takes place. Even if the primer are too far apart, even then also no amplification takes place. Amplified fragment length polymorphism. AFLP technology is a DNA fingerprinting technique that combines RFLP, that is restriction fragment length polymorphism, and PCR. It is based on the selective amplification of a subset of genomic restriction fragment using PCR. Now, it is applied in monitoring inheritance of agronomic traits, diagnostics in genetically inherited diseases, pedigree analysis, forensic typing, parentage analysis, identifying hybrids, species level relationship, also in some case at higher level relationship. The procedure for amplified fragment length polymorphism is that first the genomic DNA is digested by restriction enzymes and the adapter is ligated to both the ends of the restriction fragments. Later the PCR was done on the adapter ligated mixture using primers that target the adapter but that vary in the base at the 3' end of the primer. Polymorphism is revealed by running the amplified product of various sample on the denatured polyacrylamide gel. Functional markers are developed from polymorphic sites within the genes that actually affect target traits variation, that is based on functional characterization of polymorphism. See, if you see this picture, this is a gene and we can see the molecular marker here, which is linked to this gene. Whereas in case of functional markers, they usually present or developed from polymorphic site within the genes that casually affect target rate variation based on functional characterization of polymorphism. In recent trends in plant breeding, there are two types. One is cisgenesis and another one is intragenesis. In case of cisgenesis, both promoter and terminator are from the same species, and this gene will be transformed. Whereas in case of intragenesis, both promoter and terminator are from two different species. Even the gene which we use for the protein expression, that is also from a different species. So this is the difference between cisgenesis and intragenesis. One of the example for cisgenesis is the activation of cisgenesis in the development of potato resistance to potato blight disease. Apomixis. Seeds are formed, but the embryo develop without fertilization, without sexual process of fusion of male and female gamete. Consequently, the plant result from them are identical in genotype to parent plants. When sexual reproduction does occur, the apomixis is termed as facultative. But when sexual reproduction is absent, it is referred to as obligate. Many crop species show apomixis, but it is generally facultative. Nowadays, genes are being discovered in model plant which control apomitotic development of embryos and endosperm. This paved the way to the genetic engineering of apomixis into crop plants. Chemically induced mutant in targeted gene can be selected with increasing efficiency. Targeted gene can be mutated in a site-specific way for some trait. Some gene regulators are inheritable, and new molecule insight is being gained and epigenetic. Engineering of apomixis in crop plant is on the way. Genetic modification technology is still developing, with plastid transformation as a promising tool for eco-friendly production of bioactive protein.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.